En realidad, Hello, 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 hello. Good evening. Can you hear me?
Yes, teacher, welcome.
Thank you, thank you. Nice.
Good evening, good evening, good evening, teacher.
Thank you, Angela. Thank you for your camera. Let me turn on my camera.
Okay.
Nice. Thank
good
you.
Good evening, compañeros.
Good evening, good evening. Darwin, now it's Darwin back. The normal real Darwin is back. The original one. Until yesterday, he was Sarayala, right? He was just spending the money, buying different teams. So now he's one more time.
¿Cómo diríamos? Ya se lo gastó.
He already spent the money.
He already
spent the money. Okay.
He already spent the money.
Probably next week he will be Sir Ayala one more time, right? Because he says that he will receive another Christmas bonus.
More.
Yeah, he said that he. You see, next he will receive another Christmas bonus this coming Monday. On the 15th, it is a payday. And before the 20th, he will receive payday on the 15th. So, and before the 20th, he's going to receive another Christmas bonus.
Wow.
So
I never Christmas bonus.
You never receive any Christmas bonus?
Not yet.
Yeah, me too. We are normal people. We are poor people. Just Darwin is the only one rich right here that he has a lot of money to spend it.
The next bonus I receive, I finally January.
Oh. You see, still in January, he's going to receive bonus in January.
O enero, o sea, recibe todavía bonos en enero.
Todavía le dan otro aguinaldo en enero, dice. No.
Darwin, consígame trabajo.
¿Cuándo nos vas a llevar a trabajar a eso? Renuncio aquí ya.
Renunciamos, teacher, renunciamos. Y me voy al jefe
yeah,
diciendo,
we will go to Kimberly class, so the whole class will be there. So next
I
year,
send my curriculum.
Yeah, your CV. Send Lourdes Beatriz, please.
Okay.
Send the CV. Okay. So
the
I will
CV.
Collect it.
Okay.
I will collect it. You can send it to me. I'm going to collect the CVs and put it right there, the position that you want. Aquí puede
okay.
escoger usted si usted quiere ser
Thank
like
you.
The businessman, the I don't know, you want to be in the front desk of the office, if you want to be like the manager of the any department, so put it there. So Darwin is the how we say the CEO. You know what is the CEO?
The CEO.
The CEO. Letter C and letter O, C-O.
C-O. ¿Qué se las puede todas?
Chief officer, teacher.
What do you say, Mayra?
Chief officer.
There you go, it's the big cat, okay? El gato grande, no un gatito. El C-O es el big,
o sea, el tigre.
big cat, okay? So está el manager, está el boss, todas las altas jerarquías, pero el C-O... es el que está arriba. A veces le dicen son también, son como de sol. So el son es el que es el mero, mero tanatudo, right? El de la compañía. Y está todavía los más arriba de esos que ya pueden estar out of the country, right? En otro país, como los fundadores, qué sé yo, right? But if Darwin is the CEO, so he has the power, right?
No, the CEO of the Kimberly Clark is in Germany.
You see?
Sí, yes. It's Tom Falk.
Tom Falk.
Vaya, escribámosle a Don Tom.
Yes. Is yes.
O sea,
the
que
boss of the boss.
En Alemania.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, but still,
en serio, consigan los trabajos.
Still, Darwin, I'm going to collect the CVs, okay? And we will go all together to the same company. And so next year we will have classes in the company, okay? So since we will be together, so we will be there, okay? And we expect, right, to receive all the bonus, the extra bonus, the bonus of the bonus that you receive. Okay, so now we have, thank you, Sandrita, for your camera. Sí. Also, Rosa Elena, thank you. Now, Rosa Elena, look, now we have the normal and regular Darwin here. Okay, he's Darwin one more time because he already spent the whole money. He already spent the whole Christmas bonus. Yesterday, so did you remember that he was without camera yesterday?
Yes. Yes.
Because he was at the mall, right? He was at the mall shopping, spending the money, right? So now he's poor one more time. Well, it's not poor, but he doesn't have the extra money for the Christmas bonus, so he's Darwin. But he says that he is going to receive another bonus this coming Monday. So next week we will have Sir Ayala one more time in the class.
He lost the title today.
No le quitemos el Sir Ayala, teacher, porque de todas maneras se la va a pasar recibiendo bonos todo el tiempo de aquí hasta el otro año.
And also he's going to receive a bonus in January. That's what he says. So imagine, well, that's rich people, right? Rich, important people in El Salvador.
Famosa. Okay. It's a VIP.
It is more than VIP.
Yes, yes, more than VIP people.
More than. But anyway, so we still need to be together next week, Sir Darwin, because we have class, okay? So I know that you are in a different level, but still we will be together next week. Oh my goodness, Sir Nelson. Mr. Nelson, good evening. Now he's back.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening, good evening. Nice. Thank you for your camera. Nice. So we are going to start. Okay, we are going to start. I have a lot of people here without camera. So I will pass the attendance and I need your answer if you are here, please. Let me open the file right here because for ABC reason, it's not opened yet. Let's see, let's see, let's see. Okay, today is Thursday, right? Today is Thursday the 9th. And tomorrow it's Friday, Friday. Nice. Okay, so let me see the attendance. We have Ada Patricia. No. Adriana Stephanie.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Adri. Ana Michelle.
Present.
Thank you. Angela.
Present, teacher.
De Jesus, thank you. Darwin Edgardo.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Darwin. You are the normal Darwin today, just today.
Today he's very humble.
Yeah, yeah, because he already spent the money. Yesterday he was at the mall, so he was with a camera because he was extremely busy buying different stuff. But now he's just Darwin. Let's see, Flor de Maria. No. Gloria Elizabeth. No. Joanna Patricia. No. Lourdes Beatriz.
Present.
Thank you, Lourdes. Margarita Stephanie?
I'm here.
Okay, Margarita, I don't see your camera. Mayra Melanie?
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Nelson Edgardo?
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ofelia Orellana?
Here, teacher.
Thank you, Ofelia.
Yo creo que...
Osmin Vairas?
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Osmin. Rafael Ernesto?
Present.
Thank you, Rafael. I don't see you, Rafael. Rosa Elena?
Present.
Thank you. Sandra Gladys? Sandrita, I know you are there. Sandra. Susana Carolina? Yancy Lisbeth?
Present.
Where are you, Yancy?
No estoy en casa todavía.
Where are you?
En la calle. Estoy esperando.
My goodness, but why is so dark? Be careful, muy oscuro está ahí, no vas a robar. Okay, let's see, Zulma Rosaura.
Present.
Okay, Zulma. Nice. So we will see the attendance one more time at night, okay? We still have people coming, okay? So let's see. We are going to, yes, Sandra, don't worry. I know you are here, okay? So I see you, okay? So no problem. Nice. Okay, okay, Jancy, you are in the bus or you are in the car, but you are not driving, Jancy, or you do?
No, in this moment, no.
Okay, so somebody else is driving, right? Or is you driving? Are you driving right now?
Right now? No. But I can't come up. I have un poquito. Yo puedo un poquito, pero en este momento no estoy conduciendo.
Ah, okay. So you know how to drive, but now it's not you driving. Okay, okay, no problem, Yancy. Thank you. Nice. Let's see. Aha, Mayra. How are you today, Mayra Melanie?
Very good, teacher, because like yesterday I worked late. Today I worked from home.
Woohoo! Nice. Working from home, it's nice, amazing.
Yes,
I really like it, okay? Unfortunately, in my case, I'm not working from home for right now. I have like 2 months that I'm working from the site, okay? But I don't like it because I live in Quetzaltepeque, right? Quetzaltepeque La Libertad. And I have to travel every single day up to San Salvador, right? Salvador del Mundo. I'm in the Avenida Olímpica and those buildings over there. So I spent like 2 hours and 30 minutes to be there.
Okay.
That's terrible.
In my case, I live in Lourdes, Colón, and I work at Colonia Escalón, and the traffic is terrible.
It is. So you travel for Los Chorros, right? Carretera Los Chorros. Oh my God, that's... I use La Constitución.
is the this, other is the they, other road.
The other road in the other side, but it's almost the same. Traffic everywhere. I left my job or the building like at 5. Okay, so you can imagine today it was 6:15. Imagine 6:15, and I was close to Walmart, La Constitución. I spent 1 hour and 15 minutes just from travel from El Salvador del Mundo to Walmart, La Constitución. Oh my God, I was almost dying. That was yesterday and today, but today was even worse than yesterday. Ayer me tardé como 1 hora, y ahora 1 hora y cuarto. But that was, imagine I arrived right here at home like at almost 7 o'clock. We have the class at 8. So when I arrive, I have to see if I can eat something really quick. I have to prepare, I have to see my baby. I have to prepare his pajamas, his bed, everything. Be ready for your class and be here.
You are going to be crazy, teacher.
I'm about to. But thank God tomorrow it's Friday. Thank God next week will be the last one, okay? And we will have vacations. It's not just because I don't want to be here, it's because we really need vacations, okay? Because yes, it's not easy to be running every day and do everything really quickly, and it is like that. It is kind of sad, but that's the way it is, right? So we have to survive. Okay, yeah. Nice. Well, what about you, Lourdes, Beatriz? How are you?
Fine, teacher, thank you.
Okay, so do you work from...
I'm so tired.
Oh my God, you can tell me. Okay, so, and what about you, Beatriz? Do you work from home or... you travel to your company every day?
In especially in moments or situation, I work at home. For example, if I feel bad for flu or a specific symptom, teacher.
Okay.
Illness.
Symptoms. Well, illness, that would be enfermedades, right? But in this case, you are talking about symptoms, okay? Like COVID symptoms.
Symptoms. Okay. Mm-hmm. I work at home. Or if any partner at my work feel bad, he or she got the coronavirus, all the company work at home.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, people says that working from home, it's like our bosses, right? The boss think that we don't do nothing if we are at home, but it's not true. It's not true. No. Because we are like better, we feel comfortable, we feel better, we feel like relaxed when we are at home, right? So I really enjoy. I have the chance and the opportunity to work from home during the whole pandemic. So I was working from home like 2 years. Okay. So I just traveled to the building just like one time in a week or 2 or 3 times in a month. Okay, so I was working from home, but now, right now, I am in a new program. So I'm in a new program that's like a new business, that's like something new. And the IT department, you know, the ones that work with the computers and everything. So the IT department, they are working on have the chance and the opportunity to open the tools and the system and everything that we need from home. Okay, so remember that since this is something new, so they are like testing, right, the tools and everything to have the chance and the opportunity to work from home. So hopefully, hopefully next year, so like in January, I hope so. So I hope so. You know what is that, right? When I say I hope so, so eso espero, right? Yo espero que. So I hope so that on January, the very first days of January, so I will go back working from home. The thing is that I work with the training, okay, like with the training department. So that's why, okay, now the company, they have like, how can I say, they have like a new building, they have like a new way to work, okay, based on technology. So they have amazing rooms with big TVs in the room. We have like a touch screen board, imagine. Lo que antes veíamos solo en película, como una pantalla táctil digital, now we have it, right? So the company is investing money on those technology resources. And so we are using those tools, those extra resources, right, for the classes. So as I told you, I work with the training department. So we are working with the new people, like with the new employees. And we teach them how to use the tools, how to do the job, how to do everything. And then they are ready for the official job, okay? So that's something that I do. But I don't like to be traveling, definitely. That's the worst thing that it ever happened to me. I spent, let's see, I spent like $50. $50 a week. Imagine, just for gas.
My bus traveled from Metapan to here.
Every day.
Yeah.
Imagine from Metapan. Oh my goodness. So he spent a lot of money just in gas. Well, no, I don't really like it. That's too much traffic. Too much traffic. Incredible, incredible. But that's the way it is. So let's see, today is class 19. My goodness, time flies. So let me make a picture right here. So we will see something. We will finish the book first. Let me stop sharing this because we need to continue with the last conversation that we have here in the book. And did you remember the topic that I told you yesterday that we are going to start seeing today? ¿Quién se acuerda del tema que les dije ayer?
Assessing risk. Assessing, no. Assessing. Oh my God. Yeah. Risk? We are talking about risk and hazards.
Yeah. That's the name of the unit, right? Assessing risk. That is the name of the unit. But did you remember that I told you tomorrow we are going to start with a new topic?
Reporter speech.
Yes, there you go. That is the topic. So we...
I was looking something about this.
Okay, nice. So probably we are not gonna finish, okay? So probably we are going to start just seeing the general info about reporting speech, but that is the last topic that we have in the course, okay, in this model, okay? So that will be the last topic. And remember that we do have time next week, right? So it's not something that we have to cover today and tomorrow. We do have time, and we have to finish as well the book, right? So we have to finish with the exercise that we have pending from the unit number 4 as well. So we are good. We are good with the time. We are even more than good, more than in the top of the unit and everything. But next week we will see more details, okay? And remember that I would like to do like recaps or reviews about the topics that we covered during the whole model. So we will have like 2 days of just reviewings, okay? So let me share the screen one more time, because as I told you, we have to finish, right, the exercise that we have pending, okay? So this is the unit number 4. So this exercise, we did it yesterday, right? So we are going to start right here. Let's see. This is the unit number 4, right? And it says that we have this conversation right here. Okay, remember that we are talking about assessing risk. Okay, so we are going to talk about different issues or problems that we can have inside of the workplace, inside of the company, that can affect, right, the production, okay, the production of the company. So let's see what we have right here, exercise 2. We have read the following conversation between employees at a manufacturing plant. They are talking about the new company's safety measure plan. Okay, so you know what is a safety measure plan? They are talking about the safety measure plan. What is that? Any idea?
Es como el plan de seguridad industrial.
Okay. It's like el... ¿cómo decimos nosotros? Hay un... Debería de haber un comité de primeros auxilios, right? Un comité de emergencia.
Seguridad ocupacional.
Seguridad ocupacional, that's the work, okay? Yeah. That's the way that companies say it. And this is not something that companies invent. No es que la empresa quiso ponerle comité de seguridad ocupacional. No, esto está... under the law, okay? Para los que tienen un poquito de conocimiento de leyes.
En ahí, higiene, ¿cómo se dice higiene?
But that is like el comité de higiene, dice usted.
No, el nombre correcto que usamos en El Salvador es seguridad e higiene ocupacional.
Okay, so I know that it's like occupational something, right? So, but the thing is that that is not like just because they want to call it like that. Is this is under the law, okay? So hay un código. Creo que el Ministerio de Trabajo, si no estoy mal, es el que tiene esos reglamentos, right? Reglamentos para todas las empresas, right? So if there is a company, no sé desde qué cantidad de empleados, pero hay un manual, hay un libro, hay un documento, algo que respalda o avala estos, este tipo de comités, right? Y ahí dice de que una empresa que cuente con más de X cantidad de empleados está obligado a tener este tipo de comités. Entonces ahí, the company, they have to organize the employees because the people that is in these teams or in these groups, they are also employees, right, from the company. For example, in the building where I work, okay, this is, that is a new building, and besides that, that is new, it's also a huge, okay, it is like 8 floors or 8 levels, okay, so, well, 9 levels, okay, the building is with 9 levels, so it is huge, right, it's bigger, so they have to create those groups, okay, they have to create those groups because the law requested and because of the employee security, right, and you need to know what is like the emergency exit, okay. Darwin, in your company, since you are the CEO, since you are the CEO of the company, do you know what is the emergency door in your office?
Yes, teacher. In my office, the emergency door and the splinter in the...
Mm-hmm. Like the emergency... there are like emergency lights, emergency extinguishers, right? So that is something that it needs to be there, right? And you as an employee, you need to know where they are, right? So that is something else that you need to know. All right, here is the exit emergency door. All right, here is the alarm. All right, here is this, right? So you have to be aware about that, okay? So they have to like put like alerts, right? So here is the emergency door, okay? So and they need to put something that means that everyone can see that that is the emergency door in case if something happened, right? Well, let's see this conversation, right? They remember that they are talking about the safety measure plan, okay? In case if something happened, they need to know, oops. They need to know what is the emergency door, okay? So let's see, it says that this is a conversation between Joel and Diego. It says, Joel, gee, I have my safety goggles been stolen. I don't see them anywhere. And then Diego says, your goggles have been taken away. There are new safe measures in the plant. Have you got to be kicking, right, kicking? What are those measures about? Are you kidding, right? So my goodness, to be kidding. So what are those measures about? Then Diego says, you are required to wear ear protection, gloves, reflective vest, protection belt, helmet, jacket, rubber boots, ear plugs, store tools in proper location. Then Joel says, so my goggles and the other tools I left around here had been taken away. Then Diego says, yes, the new safety plan has been designed to prohibit scatter tools outside the tool room. Well, so let's see, probably we have new words right here. So in the first one, it says G, right? So it's referring to Diego, right? G, have my safety goggles has been stalling. What is that? Do you have any idea?
The goggles are the gafas, los lentes de protección.
Mm-hmm. Okay, nowadays usamos esas gafas nosotros por el COVID, right? Han visto que son like big ones. Okay, so antes eran solo para los que andaban trabajando. Nowadays it's common to see people upside, right, with those goggles, gafas de protección, no son sunglasses, right? Esos son para ir a la playa, estos son para trabajar. Ok, so viene y le dice, hey, mis gafas de protección han sido robadas. I don't see them anywhere, no las veo por ningún lado, right? Then Diego says, your goggles had been taken away. Me dice, tus gafas de protección se las han llevado, right? There are new safety measures in the plan. So ahí es donde él le dice, lo que pasa es que hay nuevas reglas ocupacionales dentro de la planta, o sea, dentro de la empresa, cerca de, dentro del lugar donde ellos están, ¿ok? It says, you got to be kidding, ¿ok? What are those measures about? ¿Ok? Como le dice, hey, en serio, no estás bromeando, ¿right? No estás molestándome, no estás bromeando, no me estás engañando, ¿right? What are those measures about? ¿De qué se tratan esas medidas, esas reglas, esos detalles? Le dice, ah, le dice, you are required to wear. Ah, le dice, tú tienes que usar. Wear, este wear es para usar, ¿verdad? Una prenda, la ropa, ¿ok? So you have to wear ear protection. ¿Qué es ear protection?
Protegerse del aire, ¿no?
De los oídos.
Protectores de oídos, así decimos nosotros, right? Tapones de oídos, decimos nosotros, tapones de oídos. Closed. ¿Qué son los closed?
Guantes.
Guantes. Reflected vest. ¿Qué es eso? Uh-huh. Chalecos, ¿verdad? Chaleco reflectivo, algo que va encima, como te han visto, ¿va? Un motociclista, por ejemplo, a veces usan ese tipo de chalecos que reflejan en la oscuridad la luz, right? So, para un que los vean, right? Protection belt. What is protection belt?
Como cinturón, lo que
cinturón de protección.
De seguridad.
Cinturón de seguridad, right? Cinturón de seguridad, como like the ones for the electricians, right? Se han fijado que ellos ponen su cincho ahí, mero raro, pero especial, right? For the activities that they do. Then it says helmet. What is helmet?
El casco protector.
Casco protector, like the one in the picture, right? The one in the picture. Jacket. What is a jacket?
Me bajaron un poquito.
I'm sorry.
Bye. Lo siento.
No problem.
Jacket. Chaleco.
Okay, una chamarra, así decimos nosotros, porque no es un chalequito.
Chaqueta, así. No sé, chaleco.
No es como un chalequito así de tela, una jacket es grueso, right? Una chamarra ahí tipo gruesa que le va a proteger de cualquier descarga eléctrica o contacto de electricidad, algo, right? So, rubber boots. ¿Qué son estas? Rubber boots.
Botas de goma.
Botas de goma, botas de...
O zapato de... ¿Cómo se llama? De...
At the company, my partners use wear bucket boots.
Bucket boots, so they are like plastic.
No, there are boots with una punta de hierro.
I see, I know.
Usan botas, no. Usan botas con punta de cubo. Yes.
Ah, ese es el que le dicen zapato de cubo.
Yes. Con una punta de hierro en la punta, valga la redundancia.
Okay, so I thought that the rubber boots, pensé que eran como eso.
Oh, no, in that case, rubber boots is botas de goma, entonces. Pero botas de goma in the company, it's so...
Depending on the area.
Ah, it depends the area. For example, in the supermarket, I see the people that work in the meats area. They wear rubber boots.
It's true because of the water and the everything. Water. Right?
Yeah.
Okay, so those are the special boots, right? So esas ya he visto que son unos grandes zapatones, right? Los que usan de cubo, dicen. That's the way we say it, right? Okay, then it says earplugs. What is that? Earplugs.
Es como lo mismo, los tapones de oído.
Son los protectores de oído.
Okay, tapones de oídos, right? So imagine if there's a lot of noise, right? So hay personas que trabajan en fábrica o en una empresa donde están cortando, no sé, un hierro, algo así, right? Un heavy metal or something. So the noise is annoying, right? So you have to cover your ears. Then it says store tools in proper locations. So that means that there is an area, an special area for them to use all the equipment or all the tools, right? So at the end it says, Joel, so my Googles and the other tools I left here had been taken away. So los lentes y todo, ¿verdad? Las herramientas las dejó, dice, y se lo quitaron todo, ¿ok? Se lo quitaron todo, le dice, sí, le dice. New safety plan has been designed to prohibit scattered tools outside the tool room. So, no es que se las han robado, right? Sino que el equipo, el departamento, los participantes de ese comité de seguridad ocupacional, so they take the tools and the Googles to the correct room. So it's como que hay una special area, right? So a special area for them to use those tools. It's not that they can go everywhere, okay? Nice. So we are going to practice this small conversation. Let's see, Angela. You will be Joel, and let's see, Sandra, Gladys, you are going to be Diego, okay? So Sandra and Angela, please go ahead.
Okay. Do you have my safely Googles being stored? I don't see them anywhere. Sandrita no está. ¿O sí?
Sandra? Yeah, she's here. Pero I guess she has issues with the audio. Sandra? Por algún motivo no la escuchamos, Sandra. Sí, quita el mute. Pero, ¿hable?
Your Michael.
That's weird, Sandra. I don't know why. Because you are not on mute. Pueda que sea el audífono que está utilizando que no tiene. Mm-hmm. Okay, Sandra, no problem. So, Rafael, help us, please. Be Diego.
Okay. Your Google have been taken away. There are new safety measures in the plant.
You go to be kidding. What are those measures about?
You are required to wear air protection gloves, reflective vest, protection belt, helmet, jacket, rubber boots, earplugs, store tools in proper location.
So my group in the other tool I left around here have been taken away?
Yes, the new safety plan has been designed to prohibit scattered tools outside the tool room.
Okay, thank you.
Nice, thank you. Let's see, we have time for one more.
Ahora, teacher, ahora.
Oh my goodness, Sandra, nice.
Me salí, wow. Volví a entrar.
Fuerte y claro, Sandrita, fuerte y claro. Okay. Nice. So, Sandra, you are going to be Joel, okay? Mayra, Melanie, please be Diego, please.
Okay.
Nice. Go ahead, Sandra.
Do we got?
Yeah, G. Go ahead. Yeah, you are okay. Joel. You are Joel, Sandra.
Okay. G. Hi, my safety goggles being stolen. I don't see them anywhere.
Your goggles have been taken away. There are new safety measures in the plant.
Do we go to Kaden, what are those measures about?
You're required to wear ear protections, gloves, reflective vest, protection belt, helmet, jacket, rubber boots, earplugs, store tools in proper location.
So my goggles and the other tools I left around here have been taken away.
Yes, the new safety plan has been designed to prohibit scattered tools outside the tools room.
Okay, nice, perfect. Okay, let's see. Okay, Rosa Elena, please. Be Joel and Darwin, please be Diego.
Okay. G, have my safety goggles been stolen? I don't see them anywhere.
Your goggles have been taken away. There are new safety measures in the plant.
You got to be kidding. What are those measures about?
You are required to wear ear protection, gloves, reflective vest, protection belt, helmet, jacket, rubber boots, earplugs, store tools in proper location.
So my goggles and the other tools I left around here have been taken away.
Yes, the new safety plan has been designed to prohibit scattered tools outside the tool room.
Sorry, I was on mute. So nice. Let's see. Now let's move on with the questions. Okay. So in that way, we complete this activity. Okay. So just let me take a screenshot right here. Where is the meeting? Okay, here it is. Let me take a screenshot. Okay, so what we are going to do is just answer the questions, okay? And then we are going to start with the passive voice, okay? So let me Stop sharing. I'm recording, right? See. I receive a message that the record was paused. Ojalá que no, porque if we don't record the meeting, so we are fritos, estamos fritos. Si esta grabación no sale completa. So we are 20 right now.
There's a recording in the screen.
Sure, pero...
recording.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it says recording.
But really, I didn't listen to the voice recording in progress.
Mm-hmm. No, and right now when I was sharing the screen, they see the video record has been paused. But I guess it's not, okay? So we are recording the meeting right now. So, yeah, it says recording. There you go. It says recording in progress, but I don't know. So we are going to have the rooms right now just to answer the three questions based on the reading, okay? We have 3 minutes only, then I will pass the attendance, and then we start with the reporting speech, okay? So let me open the rooms and let's work together with the answers, okay? So I know that it's tired and some of you are just listening to the class, but try to participate as much as you can, please.
And so
in other tools
and other tools. Okay. The safety goggles and some tools. Okay. The second question is, what is the new safety measure about? Debería de ser that they are required to wear ear protections, gloves, reflective vest. Eso sería, ¿verdad? No.
Aunque al final también dice Diego, the new safety plan has been designed to prohibit scattered tool upsides.
Ah, ajá. Es cierto.
Así que no sé si será.
¿Cuál de las dos opciones es?
Ajá, ¿cuál de las dos? Ajá, ¿qué dice? ¿La concurrencia?
Ajá.
Oh my goodness. Me, Rafa, ¿qué piensas? What thing?
No quieren participar, qué bárbaros.
No, pero verdad que sí está como confuso. Entonces, ¿cuál de las dos dejamos?
I think the last sentences. Diego.
The final lines of Diego.
Exactly. The new plane has been designed.
You are in the number three. You are in the question number three.
Number two, teacher.
Number two?
Number two.
But number two says, what is the new safety measure about? So the answer right here is just one. It's about the safety measures, right? That is the new safety measure about. So it's about that employees need to wear safety gear, store tools in a proper location. So that will be the information that what is about that.
Okay, the number two.
Rafa.
Creo que es the that Diego say you are required to wear air protection gloves, reflective vest protection belt in proper location. I think.
Yo sí lo tengo.
Okay. Ok, entonces required to wear a protection glove desde ahí.
Sí.
And the final question is your opinion is personal.
Sí. Es a personal opinion.
Digamos, pero. Ok. Según su opinión, ¿por qué es importante que las herramientas estén en un lugar adecuado dentro del plan?
Ajá, que no estén como dispersas.
The last one, the answer can be up to you, right? So it's your personal opinion.
All right.
Porque me puedo tropezar y me caigo.
Ajá, yo esa le puse. Because as the tools are scattered, they can cause an accident.
An incident o un accident. Un incidente o un accidente.
Ajá.
How can you lose the tools?
Ok. Y si trabajo en mi casa, puedo tropezar con un zapato.
Yeah, especially you, Darwin. Especially you.
Hey, yo soy ordenado. I am a, how do you say ordenado?
Organized.
Organized. I am a organized.
Teacher, pero hay un como el de, no, what is dirty?
That would be sucio.
Sucio.
Y lo, ajá, pero lo contrario.
Clean.
Clean.
No, pero creo que hay una palabra para.
Messi es desordenado.
Pero ordenado.
Organize.
We say organize.
Yo creo que hay otra.
Can be. We have probably a synonym. Organize.
Ah, Titi.
But your T, that is a sushi.
No. Ah, pero Titi. Oh. Sí, creo que Titi. Tidy.
No, tiny. Tiny.
Tidy. No, tidy. T. T-I-D-Y.
Read in the chat.
D. Pero ese es como nítido. Tiny. Ok, es como.
No, es tidy. Tidy. Ahí lo puse en el chat.
I don't see the chat right here.
T-I-D-Y.
Mm-hmm. Tidy, as I told you, tidy. Uh-huh. Tidy, ese es como in, or es limpio, pero nítido, decimos nosotros. Nítido, todo ordenado. Mm-hmm. Tidy. So, time is over, I have to leave. And we will see the answers in the main room. Okay, so we are back. So the last answer can be different, right? That is like personal, your personal point of view, right? It's not mandatory to have the same answer because you can think in a different way, right? So let me pass the attendance first. Let's see Ada Patricia. No, Adriana Stephanie. Ana Michelle.
Present.
Thank you. Angela.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Darwin.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Flor de Maria.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Flor. Nice to see that you are here. Nice. Gloria Elizabeth.
Here.
Thank you, Gloria. Joanna Patricia. No. Lourdes Beatriz.
Present.
Thank you, Lourdes.
Present, teacher Joanna.
Oh my goodness, Joanna. I don't see your camera, Joanna.
Estoy en el trabajo, teacher.
Oh my goodness. Let's see, Margarita.
I was here.
Thank you, Margarita. Mayra Melanie.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Mayra Melanie.
Yes.
You were here yesterday or no?
No, teacher.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, I see that you have zero. Okay, but it's nice that you are here. Okay, nice. Nelson?
Present.
Thank you, Nelson. Ophelia?
Good teacher.
Thank you. Osmi?
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Rafael?
Present.
Nice. Rosa Elena?
Present.
Nice. Sandra Gladys? Susana Carolina?
Present.
Thank you. Jancy Lisbeth.
Present.
Nice. Zulma Rosaura.
Present.
Okay, now that we are almost all in the meeting, So I would like to mention the percentage for the time that you have, okay? So ahorita el porcentaje que deberían de tener es de 72%, okay? 72%, quiere decir que entre ahora y mañana, creería yo que con la el attendance de today and tomorrow, you will get the 80%, like the minimum time, right, that you need to be connected, okay? So, pero ahorita va en con lo que tenían hasta ayer, okay, no lo de ahora. Hasta ayer debería de haber un 72% de asistencia si usted ha estado conectado todos los días en toda la sesión, okay? So, les voy a dar así rapidito el porcentaje de lo que cada uno lleva para que usted evalúe, haga cuentas, haga números y vea que cuántos minutos necesita para llegar al mínimo requerido, aunque el deber ser pues es estar en todas las video conference, right? But that's your analysis, right? So it says right here, Ada Patricia tiene 65.97. Adriana Stephanie, you have 63.80. 63.80. Ana Michelle tiene 65.20. Angela, amazing, you have 72%, so está 100%. The same story, Darwin, you have 72%, nice. Flor de María tiene 51.13. Gloria Elizabeth tiene 65.67. Joana Patricia, 23.40. Lourdes Beatriz, 60%. Margarita Stephanie, 35.20. Mayra Melanie, 60.90. Nelson Edgardo, 60.13. Ofelia, 71.97. Excelente, prácticamente tiene el 100. Osmin, 71.93, excelente, igual, casi pues está con 100%. Then we have Rafael Ernesto, 63.90. Rosa Elena, 67.93. Sandra Gladys, let's see, Sandra Gladys, 61.53. Susana Carolina, 47.93. Yancy Lisbeth, 67.57. En Zulma Rosaura, 60.07. Ok, so eso es el porcentaje que se tiene de asistencia de manera individual y up to yesterday, right? So ahí no está incluido el día de ahora, eso habría que sumarlo ahí, ¿verdad? Pero sí, anda por ahí el percentage de la attendance para que usted tenga una idea cómo va y no falte la otra semana que ya sería la última, right? Y usted necesita llegar a un mínimo de 80, ¿ok? A un mínimo de 80 para poder aprobar. Así que ahí está el dato para que tengan una idea de cómo vamos. Let me share the screen, pero no me aparece la opción. Aquí está. So, let's see. Okay, so Nelson, number one, please read the question and tell us your answer.
What item is your elbow looking for? It's a question.
the answer in separate groups.
Okay. Where,
yeah.
Joel, Joel, it's looking for the safety goggles, okay? So eso es lo que se le ha perdido, right? Es lo que anda buscando. Nice. Let's see, Ophelia. Number two. Ophelia, you are on mute.
Hello, teacher.
Number two.
Okay, number two. What is the nice staffing needs most I book? Is Bear, Hillman, Jacken, Rubber, Box, Air, Plus, Store, Turling in Roy.
Okay, so that is what it's about. So I don't know if someone has a different answer. Let's see, let's see, let's see who. Well, Rafael, I don't know if you have something different in the number two. Rafael Ernesto.
It is
number two.
I have same.
You have the same? So you have like the list, right? Like the list of everything that they mention, okay? So here in the book, it says that the new safety measure will have employees wear safety wear, and then they list, right? Then they list the items, right? Or the tools that they mention, okay? Nice. Let's see, number three will be for Lourdes, Beatriz, please. Number three.
In your opinion, why should tools not be scattered in the production plant? In my opinion, the glass glasses and belt safety.
Okay, they protect your eyes, right, in case if something
and helmet
happened. The helmet, okay. The helmet protects your head, right? Yes. So and did you realize that when constructors are working, okay, people that works in a construction, they are always with a helmet, right? So they are always with a helmet, a special clothes, a special shoes to protect themselves, right? So to protect themselves. Yes. Nice. Okay, so we are going to stop right there. Probably there are different answers because that is like a personal answer, right? So no todos iban a poner lo mismo. Iba a depender de la opinión de cada uno, right? So, but we are going to continue with this. Passive voice. We have the famous passive voice right here. How to use passive voice with the present perfect. Okay, so passive voice. So this is something that we will see, okay? We will see, I have some examples about reported speech as well. So these topics are related because of the tenses, okay? We have the passive voice that is also like the reported speech, okay? So you will see reported speech. Reported speech is when we say or when we mention or we say something that somebody else say it, right? So we will see, we will see. Let's see who, Mayra, Melanie, please help us with the reading right here, how to use.
Okay. The passive voice is used when the emphasis of the sentence is on the action and not on the subject. Number one, your googles have been taken away. In contrast to, they have taken your googles away. In sentence one, the person who took away the Google is not important. The fact that they were taken away in instead emphasis.
Okay, okay, nice. So it says right here, the passive voice, okay? How we say this in Spanish, passive voice?
Voz pasiva.
La voz pasiva, okay? We have that in Spanish, okay? Busquen en la gramática española, right? So we do have that in Spanish. Voz activa y voz pasiva, okay? Para los que han en algún momento estudiado la gramática de nuestro idioma, so pueden ver esa parte de la active voice and passive voice, okay? Voz activa.
Voz media, or sa.
Media, I don't know if we have media in Spanish, but I know we have the passive voice and the active voice. So the passive voice is used when the emphasis of the sentence is on the action and not on the subject, okay? The passive voice is used when the emphasis of the sentence is on the action and not on the subject, okay? So in a school, when you are learning how to write, how to use tenses, a usted enseñan en la escuela que tiene que hacer una oración y le dicen, ah, la oración la tenés que poner el sujeto, verbo, predicado, así le enseñan a uno en Spanish, right? So el passive voice is used to emphasize in the sentence the action, okay? The action instead of the subject. Normalmente el sujeto es como lo más importante, right? En una oración, usted dice, Chepito vino a comer. So lo más importante es que Chepito, right? So the person, Chepito vino a comer. But in this case, the passive voice, it's the opposite, okay? It is on the action, okay? La acción, comió, okay? So the action is more important than the subject itself, okay? No importa si fue Chepito, Juan, Marillita, Pablito. Lo importante aquí es la acción. Okay, so look at the example. Aquí tenemos el primer example, right? Your googles had been taken away. So, mira esta oración, tiene sujeto, verbo, complemento. Okay, but what is important right here is this. Had been taken away. So, no me importa de quién, no me importa quién los tiene, qué pasó. Lo importante in this sentence is the action. Letter B, they have taken your Googles away. They, okay, they have taken your Googles away. So Googles away, so este vendría siendo el sujeto aquí, right? So your Googles. So, what is important right here is the action, okay? The action. It says in sentence 1A, the person who took away the Googles is not important. So, ni lo dice, right? So, dice your Googles had been taken away. So, ahí no explica, no dice quién, una persona como Chepito te agarró tus gafas. No, right? Ahí no dice quién. So, what is important there? It's that the Googles are not there, right? The fact that they were taken away, it's instead emphasized, okay? So eso es lo que está haciendo emphasize right here, Googles away. So, one more time. El passive voice, okay? In the passive voice, la voz pasiva, okay? So, the emphasis is on the action, okay? Keep in mind. Lo que importa es la acción, más que quién lo hizo. Como que usted llega a la refri y dice, ¿quién se comió mi pan? ¿Quién se comió mi sorbete? Right? So, usted está más que diciendo, Juanito se comió mi pastel, right? So, más que diciendo, who did it? Hello, hello, can you hear me?
Hello. No veo.
Hello, hello.